guys, welcome back to the channel, and today I'm going to be reading our new Islamic Studies series for this summer. Chapter 1, Rewards of Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. A reward is a gift given to someone to recognize his or her good work. A reward could be a certificate, a trophy, a medal, or a job promotion. When we do a good job, we expect a reward. Teachers reward us when we do well on an exam. Parents reward us when we do something great. Sometimes the rewards are simple words of encouragement or a gift. Rewards make us happy and encourage us to do more good things to get more reward. When we do something that pleases Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He rewards us too. His rewards are not words of admiration. His rewards are not a certificate of a medal of honor. He rewards us with something that actually benefits us. His rewards are the best rewards. He rewards us in this life, and He will reward us more in the hereafter. If your good work is noticed by someone, then you might expect to get a reward. If your teacher or parents do not notice your good work, there will be no reward. Sometimes teachers and parents notice good work, but they do not give reward. Sometimes they reward you for one good deed, but if you do 10 or 20 good deeds in one day, you do not get 10 or 20 rewards. But this is not so with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He notices every small or big deed of each and every person. Based on the quality of one's actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards the person. For one small good deed, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala usually rewards many more times. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards everyone. Rewards are not limited to only a few people or to human beings alone. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala rewards animals and plants too. He does not grow tired of giving rewards. Often we receive gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for no particular good deed. The water we drink and the air we breathe are such gifts from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He loves us. Therefore, He gives us these gifts. We receive some rewards for working hard. For a farmer, the reward for taking care of the crops in the garden is a good harvest. When we study, we receive rewards in the form of good grades in school. After finishing college, we will get a good job. With the money we earn, we can buy a house, food, and clothes. All these things are rewards for working hard. All these rewards exist only because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives them to us. He is the best giver. Sometimes He gives rewards in the form of happiness or joy. Sometimes He gives rewards in the form of good health and peace of mind. When we spend money in ways that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala approves of, He multiplies our wealth. Al-Baqarah chapter 2 verse 261. The parable of those who spend their wealth in the way of Allah is like the parable of a grain which grows into 7 ears. In every ear 100 grains. And Allah multiplies for whom He pleases. For Allah is ample giving, all know. There are certain situations where we may not get our reward right away. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has asked us to be patient or to have sabr. This is because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows the best time to reward us. We should remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala never forgets to give a reward. In the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, chapter 35, verse 29, certainly those who recite the book of Allah and establish the salah and spend out of what we have provided them with, secretly and openly, they can hope for a deal that will never run out. When Nabi Ibrahim alayhi wasallam and his son Ismail alayhi wasallam built the Kaaba, they prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept their effort. Their prayer was Al-Baqarah chapter 2 verse 127. Our Rabb, accept from us. You indeed, You are the all-hearing, the all-knowing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepted their dua and made Makkah the center of Hajj. People started going to Makkah on foot and on camels, coming from nearby and far-off places. The Kaaba became well-known to people as the place to worship one God. Thousands of years later, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made the Kaaba our Qibla, the direction in which we pray. This reward is so great that over the centuries, billions of Muslims have made their salat facing the Kaaba. Life in this world is not the end of everything. There is life after death. A day will come when everything will end and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make us alive again to face judgment. After the day of judgment, the good people will go to Jannah, or heaven. This is the ultimate reward. We all must work hard to get this reward. This reward will not be given unless we qualify. We cannot even imagine how grand Jannah will be. Our reward in Jannah will be even more than what we want. Once we are in Jannah, we will stay there forever. Chapter 4, verse 57. And as to those who believe and do good, we shall let them enter gardens under which flow the rivers, living in it forever. For them there will be in it pure companions, and we shall admit them to a dense shame. As previously mentioned, sometimes we do good work but do not get enough rewards. While in school or doing chores, we do a lot of good work, but we do not always get recognized for our work. With Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, our good work is always noticed. Our good deeds are always carefully recorded. There is no chance that our reward may go to someone else by mistake. It is also not possible that someone can take away our reward. If everyone at school receives a medal for doing good deed, there may not be enough medals for everybody. However, Allah's rewards never run out. His reward is not like a medal or a trophy in a game that only one person receives. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can reward as many people as He wants. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watchful over everything. Even if we do not ask Him, He rewards us for every good deed. The reward is always better than a good deed. If we ask Him by making a dua, He may give us much more than we ask for. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala teaches us many dua in the Quran, and many are listed in the books of hadith. We all want to get rewards from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Some of Allah's gifts are free, such as air, water, and the environment. The best rewards are not free. We must earn them. We can earn these rewards by obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, obeying our messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and following the guidelines given in the Quran and the sunnah of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Sunnah means the examples of the messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe.